you're missing out on a lot. Mm-hmm. First part, it's natural. Uh-huh. It's not processed.
I get what you're saying.
Growing up with that, you can eat all you want, and you won't have the backlash of eating processed food stuff. So, eat and eat and eat until you can't eat no more. We started during the COVID lockdown, and during that period, we grew in leaps and bounds. Because we are dealing mostly in natural products. Then down the line, we started diversifying here and there. We get sweets from Turkey.
Yeah, you can start. So you can tell us your name.
My name is Micheal. I'm from Tamam Delicacies. We deal mostly in Swahili dishes. We have kashata, achari, labania, and all types of sweets. We are a Muslim family. So we wanted to share part of our culture with the rest of the community.
That's interesting how you say that. You said it like it's in a, like it was set for you to do it. It's something you can experiment. It's in your like community.
Yeah, yeah.
Break that down for us.
The family background, we usually had these sweets from the coastal region of the country. So we can't keep all that sweet goodness to ourselves. So we share.
What is it about like the growing up in that community where this is an economic activity? What is it you see among us where it's culture that lacks in how we who are not from the culture say consume sweets? Or like, what are we missing out?
You're missing out on a lot. Mm-hmm. First part, it's natural. Uh-huh. It's not processed.
I get what you're saying.
Growing up with that, you can eat all you want, and you won't have the backlash of eating processed food stuff. So, eat and eat and eat until you can't eat no more.
That is amazing. And like, given that now you have this source of information,
yeah,
and you have these saving maybe the craftsmanship and just everything that you know from it, that is of course more than people who were not born around that. Yeah. What business opportunities does that make you see?
From the business perspective, from sourcing it from the coastal region, towards it's cheap. We bring it here, we make a little money on the side to keep the business running.
That's amazing. Because from just what you've said, especially it being natural, do you know if people have had a way of getting that information out around your business,
yeah,
that's all you need to sell this?
Yeah, we try and educate our clients on that base. And it has helped us grow by huge margins over the past year. We started during the COVID lockdown, and during that period, we grew in leaps and bounds. Because we are dealing mostly in natural products. Then down the line, we started diversifying here and there. We get sweets from Turkey. We add them to the list.
So, and besides now having the home ground advantage,
yeah,
what are the limitations or hindrances that you still meet on while doing
part
it?
Part of the limitations, first, when you order stuff from the coast, it takes a few days to get to us. Sometimes you have orders like, we need this and this today, you don't have it in stock. Tell the client you need a few days to wait for it to get here. But then clients are clients. They move to another place. But we are glad we have some very solid clients. They stick with us through thick and thin.
So why do you think exhibitions is a good place to come and showcase this?
Diversifying. We want to move from our normal clientele base to a new one. We want to expand. And we saw this as a good opportunity for that.
Nice. Any other exhibitions you've gone to or you're experimenting with this as the first one?
We've been to Azana Gardens like 2 weeks ago. It was a good experience, and we thought, why not keep it going? So we are here now.
Nice. Remind people your name and tell them the name of your business again and where they can find you online.
My name is Micheal. I'm from Tamam Delicacies. On Instagram, we are Tamam Delicacies. We have a physical shop. It's in Pangani, opposite Jubilee House.
And online?
Online, still Tamam Delicacies on Instagram.
Nice. Nice, bro.